Now, here's a good question that you need to find the answer to. Since mankind is carbon-based, scientifically speaking, we're all carbon-based, how do these synthetically created hydrogen and carbon-hungry bacteria react to human flesh? I'll tell you exactly how. And these are why these are unique symptoms. Internal bleeding, as well as ulcerated skin lesions, are the physical signs of that computer-created DNA signature. And if you don't believe that, find a science lab to do a DNA test. That was one of the things that puzzled me so much about our water sample. I sent it to a person in outside North America national university lab. This person is a research biologist and virologist, studies viruses, and is also head of the whole department at the National University. Now, with that water sample, I was told 4 weeks ago that they could not figure out the DNA signature on the bacteria that was in that water. They were trying to compare it to everything from Ebola bacteria to other bacteria, all the other bacteria that are known, that are in the textbooks, that are found in oceans and even the Gulf of Mexico. They could not match up that DNA signature. And they stopped doing work on those samples because there is no such DNA signature that's in the books anywhere. Now that is why I know it's a synthetic bacteria that's there now. That's the reason that this article is so important. If a professional has taken a water sample and identifies that there is a DNA and certain bacteria there, but it is not the DNA of the natural bacteria that are known, interesting, isn't it? So BP and their paid minions have released a synthetic biological plague. I really mean it when I say a synthetic biological plague. And they've released it in the Gulf of Mexico to get rid of the oil and possibly released even more to make the oil flow faster out of the wells and possibly blew up the freaking well doing it. The entire world is a victim of what they've done in the Gulf of Mexico with their synthetic biological plague. The internal bleeding, ulcerated skin lesions, bleeding out of rectum, out of vaginas, out of ears, out of noses, out of eyes. Organs just bleeding like crazy. That's what's really going on around the Gulf of Mexico. I know you haven't had it in the news. That's because BP and the U.S. federal government say it's all over pretty much. No, it's not. It's getting worse. And this is why it's getting worse. Now, can you understand why they couldn't allow hurricanes to come into the Gulf of Mexico and spread this around the world? Those who have allowed and agreed to the cover-up about this are just as responsible as BP. Those of us who live on the Gulf Coast, we need to demand, not ask, but absolutely demand of every single politician, every government agency, all the alphabet agencies they've got roaming around here with a heads up somewhere, you know where. FEMA comes to mind. Of course, BP's no better, but we have to demand answers from them. All the way from the local level of our local governments, all the way to the national level. We need an explanation. Not only as to why they allowed it to happen, starting February 13th when BP had their meeting at the White House with Obama, why they allowed it to happen, and even more, I want answers as to who's responsible for allowing it to continue. And whoever is responsible, they and BP need to be put on trial. Not for civil charges, criminal charges. Matt Simmons was right. That's what the cover-up was all about. BP and all the rest who are in the cover-up with them, and it looks like every alphabet kind of agency or department that you can think of between national and local and state and county and every other kind of government and even private, they're all responsible for lying to us and covering up the truth. So now let me describe the final picture. Two blue, round cells growing in a petri dish. Colonies that are beginning, and they're blue. Now you know why I named it the blue flu. And that picture that's on our site and on Jeff Rentz's site, Rentz.com, about the Gulf blue plague, that picture is right there, a synthetic transform bacteria controlled totally by synthetic DNA. That's the kind of stuff we got in the Gulf. That's why everybody goes, well, it comes on like flu symptoms, but it's a whole lot worse. Yeah, it's a whole lot worse because this stuff is in us. It's in the air and it's in the water. Now, it does affect those in the water the most. It takes a lot of exposure of actually living right along the edge of the water where all this oil is. And remember, wherever the oil is where the synthetic bacteria is. They eat it up. Now, that explains why a lot of people go, well, there's some weird colors to this stuff that's coming up out of the bottom and floating on the surface. Yeah, it's being eaten up by a synthetic genome-controlled bacteria. And yes, that stuff's getting in the air, and it's all over the water, and it's on the beaches. It's everywhere, and it's going to keep on eating. And it apparently just loves the heck out of human flesh. Take a look at the pictures on the internet with Project Gulf Impact of Kendra Arneson, and look at that ulcerated lesion on her, and she said, oh, you should have seen the ones that were on my back. We have neurological problems as well. And I can say that I'm one of them that has those problems because I got fingers on my left side that tingle constantly now. And I know that I was exposed a couple times going out of my boat. I've hardly had any exposure compared to those that are living along the Gulf up north in Louisiana, Mississippi, and Alabama, and Texas, and the north coast of Florida. But apparently I've had enough. I'd like to know why the cover-up is there. Not only like to know, I demand to know. I absolutely flat-out demand to know. And that's why I'm asking everybody who's listening, and even if you're listening in the archives, go to our site, worldvisionportal.org. Go look at the article there. Go to Rentz.com. Go in his featured section. Go pull the article off of there. If you're in our chat room right now, our live chat, get those links down. Take a picture of the page if you have to, or don't sign off until you can get all the links down. These are all part of putting the picture together. Yeah, the blue flag, the Gulf blue flag, is about as real can be, and it's synthetic. And that is why the symptoms are not symptoms of anything else that's been known, and that is why there is a DNA signature on that particular unknown, previously unknown, as the scientists said, their quote, unknown oil-eating bacteria in the deep water. Well, it's known. We're going to have to come up with a name with it. I mean, we got Cynthia. I just call it, you know, Cynthia's cousin. Maybe we'll have a contest to find out what it is that looks like it's going to kill a lot of people. Why don't we call it BP Hell? I think all these people need to be criminally charged. And that comes from everybody at BP to those who created these new life forms. What the hell do they think they're doing with the world? And look at what they've done to people who live the Gulf, who live along the Gulf. Most of the people have been fighting so hard to get the truth out about the Gulf, they're exhausted and sick. And people like Pensacola Greg, he wiped everything off of his internet site and his blogs and Facebook and everything else after he was on Jeff Rant's show. He gives up. He's just too sick and too tired, and even his neighbors won't listen to him. And I know that feeling. Mine won't listen to me either. But I'm not giving up. I found out what they released into the Gulf. Thank God I had the vision to see it. And that's the only reason I knew it was there. And now I just gave you all the proof. It's there. It's really there. And it's synthetic. And it's a new life form. And it doesn't work well with mammals. The porpoises die. You know, we're mammals just like porpoises and whales. It's no wonder it ate their flesh. It eats ours too. That's how serious it is. You want this around the world? Sooner or later, it's gonna be around the world. It's gonna happen. Just take the warning from those of us who have to live through it now. Because enough is enough. We're used as guinea pigs in a synthetic genomic experiment. And enough is enough. And if you live along the Gulf Coast, I hope you find this program. And I hope you get as indignant and pissed off as I am. I live here. I don't want to move. But I don't want to be the victim of criminals either. And yep, I'm calling it for what it is. What BP has done is criminal. And they need to be charged. But then when those who are covering them up are the ones who are supposed to have the courts to charge them, I seriously doubt that'll happen unless we can change those who control the courts and the rest of the governments. So maybe it's time for that. To allow this to happen and to allow people to have their skin and their organs eaten alive by a genetically unknown synthetic bacteria is more than criminal.